Good morning, my dear students. Once again, welcome back to Social Science Revision Online Teaching Classes from Vishwamanava Residential High School. My dear students, in the last class, we have learnt 1 marks question and answers and 2 marks question and answers in the lesson Indian Natural Disasters. Now, let us continue part discuss through the 3 marks question and answers in the lesson Indian Natural Disasters. Okay, let's start. Second main, first question. List out the major natural disasters. All of you know that the major natural disasters like cyclones, floods, landslides, coastal erosion, earthquakes, tsunami, volcanoes, rocks, etc. So these are the major natural disasters, isn't it? Next question. What are the factors that caused the origin of tropical cyclones? What are the factors? The factors like one is high temperature, second one is climate, third one is highly saturated air. So these are the factors that caused the origin of tropical cyclones. Then third question, how do cyclones occur? Are cyclones mostly found in tropical zone over the seas? Why? Or explain the process of occurrence of cyclones in India. Answer. The most ideal conditions for the origin and development of tropical cyclones are the factors I already told you. The factors, one is high temperature, second one is climb air, and third one is highly saturated air. Then the second main condition, these conditions result in the development of low pressure center. And third point, the relative high pressure provides around the low pressure. So the winds blows spherically inwards the center of low pressure causing cyclones. So such conditions are found in tropical zone, especially over the seas. So this is about the cyclones. Next question, what are the precautionary measures can be taken to prevent cyclone? What are the precautionary measures? So very important, what are the precautionary measures can be taken to prevent cyclones? Answer. The first point, to create awareness through radio and television. That is the main precautionary measures. Then second point, temporary shelters should be provided during the cyclones. Then third point, cyclone proof structures can be constructed. And the last point, mangrove forest and other deep rooted trees can be grown along the coastal line to check the impact of cyclone winds and the soil erosion. So this is about the precautionary measures of cyclones, isn't it? Next, fifth question, mention the natural causes for floods. Or how do natural factors lead to floods? Answer. The natural causes for floods, one is heavy rainfall, second one is melting of snow, third one is tropical cyclones, fourth one is cloud burst, and fifth one is blockage of the free flow of river water, and the last one is silting river beds. So this is about the natural causes for floods. Next, sixth question, how do man-made factors cause floods? Or what are the main man-made factors that causes floods? Or today most of the floods occur in the world are caused by man-made factors. How? Answer. The man-made factors causes floods like deforestation, irrigation, agricultural practice, breaching of barrages and rapid urbanization. So this is about the man-made factors causes floods. Next question. What are the reasons for floods? Or how do natural and man-made factors cause floods? What are the reasons? See, the main reason. See, the main reasons for floods like heavy rainfall, melting of snow, tropical cyclones, cloudburst and blockage of the free flow of the river water and the silting river beds. So this is about the causes or reasons for floods. Next, 8th question. Which are the flood prone areas in India? Or name the flood prone areas of India. Keep it mind. Answer: the Ganga and the Brahmaputra river basin. Second point, the Sutlej, the base, then the Ravi and the Chenab. Then third point, the peninsular India, the deltic areas of river basin and the lower parts of Narmada and Tapi river basin. Example, it is in Gujarat. So this is about the areas. Next question. Name, explain the flood control measures. Or what are the measures can be taken to control floods? What are the measures? Like first point, afforestation in the catchment area. Second point, constructions of dam across the river. Third point, flood forecasting and early warnings. And the last point, constructions of embankment for the protection against inundation of the inhabited areas and agricultural land. So this is about floods control measures. Next, 10th question. List out the causes for landslides. Or how do natural and human induce forces causes to landslides? See, the natural and human causes. See, this question is asked in the year 2019 March for 3 marks. See here, what are the main causes of landslides? One is natural force or natural causes. Second one is human causes. In the natural causes, we can see undercutting of the slope as in sea waves, erosion of a sea cliff. That is the main causes. Earthquake, heavy rainfall. These are the natural causes for landslides. Then human force or human causes like deforestations, constructions of roads, railway lines, dams and receivers, hydroelectric power, mining, quarrying, etc. So these are the human force. So this is about the causes for landslides. Next question. What are the measures can be taken to prevent landslides? Or how can we control landslides? Answer. The precautionary measures can be taken to prevent landslides like slope reduction, prevention of rock falls along highways and another slope, then avoiding of mining and quarrying activities near the steep slopes and human settlement and buildings, and there should be a massive reforestation. So this is about the measures can be taken to prevent landslides. Then next to 12th question, what are the causes for coastal erosion in India? Or what are the natural and man-made factors of coastal erosion? Answer. First off, natural factors. In the natural factors, all of you know that monsoon winds, tropical cyclones, tsunami. So this is about the natural factors. The another site, man-made factors. Man-made factors like removal of sand, constructions, breakwater. So this is about the man-made factors. So this is about the causes for coastal erosion in India. Next, 13th question. What are the effects of coastal erosion? What are the major effects? Answer. First point, coastal areas including trees and buildings can be washed away. Second point, the roads, railway lines, bridges, etc. along the coast can be damaged. And third point, coastal areas can remain flooded over a long period of time, requiring resettlement of people. So this is about the effects of a coastal erosion. Next question, how can we control coastal erosion, or what are the measures to be taken to prevent coastal erosion? Answer. The precautionary measures to be taken to prevent coastal erosion, like reconstruction seawalls, breakwaters, grounds to protect the coastal areas from wave erosion. Second point, restrict sand mining in coastal areas. Third point, planting of trees, the beaches and coastal dunes. Next question, what are the causes for earthquakes? What are the main causes? Answer, plate movements, volcanic eruption, faulting and folding, landslides, collapse of underground cave roof, hydrostatic pressure of man-made water bodies like reservoirs. So this is about the causes for earthquakes. Next question, name the earthquake zones in India. Answer, the earthquake zones in our country, one is the Himalayan zone, second one is Indo-Gangetic zone, third one is Peninsular zone. So these are the earthquake zones in India. Next question, what are the effects of cyclones? Are tropical cyclones are very destructive, justify? Or what are the effects of floods? Are landslides are destructive natural disasters? How? Or what are the effects of landslides? Or what are the effects of earthquakes? Are earthquakes are destructive natural disasters? How? See, first you can observe the question and let's we move on. Answer. The major effects of these natural disasters, like one is loss of life and property, second point, damage to buildings, third point, damage to crops and vegetation, and breakdown of communication and power supply, dislocation of a transport system, soil erosion and a dispute of essential services. So this is about the effects of natural disasters. The natural disasters like cyclones, floods, earthquakes, landslides, coastal erosion, etc. Isn't it? Next question. Mention the precautionary measures to be taken to reduce the effects of earthquakes. Or what are the precautionary measures can be taken to reduce the effects of earthquakes? Answer. Avoid the human settlements in the earthquake prone zones and follow earthquake resistant designs for the constructions of buildings. Third point, use buildings materials of high quality and avoid high rise buildings. Fourth point, restrict the overground water mining. Fifth point, restrict urban growth in the hilly areas with high seismic vulnerability. Then avoid the constructions of large dams and reservoirs, and stop deforestation and heavy quarrying activities. So this is about the effects, precautionary measures to taken to reduce the effects of earthquakes. Then the next question, what are the remedial measures can be taken after the occurrence of earthquakes? And what are the remedial measures can be taken after the occurrence of natural disasters such as earthquakes, landslides, floods, etc.? Isn't it? What are the remedial measures? See, the remedial measures like emergency, recuse, operations, supply of foods, rehabilitation, control of contagious diseases and provide medical facilities. So this is about the remedial measures can be taken after the occurrence of natural disasters, isn't it? See, that is effects of natural disasters, loss of life and property, damage to buildings, damage to crops and vegetation, breakdown of communication and power system, dislocation of transport system, soil erosion and disruption of essential services. So this is about the effects of natural disasters. And remedial measures can be taken after the occurrence of any natural disaster, such as the natural disasters like earthquakes, coastal erosion, floods, landslides, etc. The remedial measures, emergency recourse, operations, then supply of foods, rehabilitations, control of contagious diseases and provide medical facilities. So this is about the remedial measures and effects of natural disasters. These are the very important question and answers in the lesson Indian Natural Disasters. Okay, my dear students, in today's video we have learnt 3 marks question and answers in the lesson Indian Natural Disasters. In this lesson we have learnt 1 marks, 2 marks and 3 marks question and answers. Okay, my dear students, thank you.